Hi everyone, my name is Dory, and Michelle and I are here to do a video in Lumi. I hope you enjoy the video. It's going to be about, I think, grocery shopping or something to do with grocery stores, Michelle said. So, and if you like this video, you can describe it at Michelle's YouTube. And I get tongue-tied. I don't know what to say half the time. But I'm planning on doing another video on my show pretty soon. And I was talking to Julia downstairs, and she said that she enjoyed doing the video with me. So, I don't know. I have a cake mix, and I don't know, maybe I can get Julia to come up here. And we could do another video. It's a cake out of a box. I know people don't like to see that, but it'd be interesting. But here's Michelle and Lumi. So, hi, Michelle.
Hi. Today's video is, first of all, let me make sure the camera is center. Can you move over a tiny bit or just scooch over a bit? I'm going to try to get this camera center because I didn't get a chance to finish doing this. We're using the shitty lens, not the good ones, which kind of sucks, because the good ones are better, in the sense that we can get Dory, me, and part of the fame, anyway, in the shot. I did some, I checked my news like I usually do every morning, and I saw that there is a discussion about the possible return of physical stores in retail in the next 5 to 10 years. They tend to use a term called brick and mortar. I don't think Dory knows what that means necessarily. Basically, a brick and mortar store is a physical store location that you might see in a strip mall or in a close mall. During the last 10 years, malls had been losing a lot of stores as people were not going out to the malls as much because of the Great Recession, as they call it, which was kind of not helped by Barack Obama's Obamacare policies, which I'm proud to say is the Republicans have managed to get up the necessary people to go for a repeal vote. But they're trying to design a replacement for Obamacare. One of the things that they want to keep from Obamacare, which I agree, is if you have an existing health condition, they should not be allowed to cancel your coverage. Number two, you should be able to buy medical coverage from any state in the United States. In other words, insurance companies should be allowed to work across state lines. And number three, you shall be allowed to continue receiving your parents' coverage at a time you're 25, 26 years old and graduate from high school, from college. That's all well and good. But it's going to be a tough uphill fight because Obamacare also has had a very negative impact on retail as well. Many people who worked full-time in retail were laid off because the stores did not or could not afford to provide them with company-provided health insurance. And so that was the creation of the part-time job. Boom, if you want to call it that. The average millennial, which is about Dory's daughter's age, is making 20% less and paying a lot more in expenses than the same baby boomer or even Generation X, which includes me, at the same age. Because they seem to be settling more expenses and debts associated with trying to struggle with an economy that's stinks. So, to read this report, it sounds like now with the new age of urbanization of people returning to the cities, they believe it may be feasible for stores to open up more locations. Even if it's more like more of a receiving or a place where like a consumer's kind of thing where you can order something and if they don't have it in the store, they can go ahead and get to the warehouse and they can bring it back to the store for you. Amazon Prime is kind of doing the same thing, but now they want to do it with dirigibles and drones. But other stores are also working with different companies to make sure that there's always, if you order something, you can pick up at the store within an hour. Like clothing, for example. What do you think about that, Dory?
That'd be interesting.
For our generation, that isn't really going to do much different than what we're doing now. A lot of us go into a store. And there's a lot of reasons why we go into a store. Number one, you like to be able to test and try the merchandise. You like to be able to go into a store and see, for example, if it's a piece of clothing, does it physically fit? If it's a piece of consumer electronics, before we invest our money in it, we like to look at it in person, feel it, see how, you know, how it feels in our hands. How do the controls work? Is it built well? Things like that you can't do online. So in some ways, the storefronts are becoming showrooms instead of storefronts. But that doesn't stop you from buying a product, especially if you can use the online app in addition to your local store. In other words, if I want to find out, for example, if a certain item is in my store, so let's say Walmart.com, I go to Walmart.com, I use the app, and I want to check the Torrington store, and I want to see if they have a certain product in stock. If they do, I'm more likely to go and get that product locally than order from a central warehouse in Benton, Arkansas, and have it delivered by, you know, either by the Postal Service or by FedEx or UPS, which is at the risk of always being stolen anyway. So by actually picking it up at the store, not only do I get a chance to look at it close up, but I also get the advantage of making sure that no one's going to steal my shit when I'm waiting for the package to arrive in the mail in the first place. And that's another convenience, too. If you happen to be living near that store, you get the convenience of no waiting. Or not significant waiting. Another thing that is making a return, and some people may be shocked to see this. Dory, you may know what this is, but you may not know much about it. You ever see slides?
Oh, yeah, those little things you put in the machine?
Right. Well, Kodak is just reintroduced Ektachrome in 35mm format again. It will be available for sale in larger quantities by the end of 2017.
That'd be cool.
In other words, Kodak is increasing their film line, and they're also making a brand. Now, this is kind of expensive, I'm not going to lie. It's because it's pretty cool, but it's kind of expensive. They're coming up with a brand new Super 8 movie camera with a twist. Not only does it shoot standard Super 8 movie film, but it also has a micro SD card slot on it to record the sound. So in other words, you can record the sound under micro SD card, and you get the movie, right? So you, according to some people, Kodak, you can give the micro SD card and its associated film cartridge to Kodak's processing center, and they'll make you a sound movie out of the stuff you send them. Because the sound is in sync with the picture.
Okay.
I think that's kind of cool.
Pretty neat.
Of course, some of my contemporaries are probably going, big deal. Well, it is a big deal because a lot of people do prefer film. Just like I shoot in standard definition, that's my preferred format. However, I can be honest and say it. Your choice of lens can make a difference. This is a cheap, crappy, shitty CCTV camera lens. I'm not using a really good one right now because, unfortunately, the really good one isn't. I'm gonna do an experiment, Dory. And my audience, I'm gonna do an experiment with you too. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm going to put on a preferred lens on this camera. I'm gonna need to move the camera a little bit, okay? And when we return, we're gonna have the same shot with a good camera lens as best we can, so we can show you the difference between cheap, shitty lens and good lens.
I think it's really cool how Michelle can do this stuff. I really, really do. Okay, Michelle has changed the lens on the camera to show you the difference between the two lenses. Let's see what happens during this video, and hopefully you'll see the difference in the video.
The lens we have now is an original lens from the 1930s. Okay, and this is made out of all glass. And it's the one that you should use for everyday videos. I focus it a little faster than I normally do, but it's, I prefer this lens because it seems to have a sharper picture. That's one of the things that I want to get when talking about cameras. There are people who like to say that standard definition stinks. I'm talking about TV format. Well, it ain't necessarily the concept of standard definition that stinks, but what it is in the last 30 years, cameras have gotten cheaper and cheaper and cheaper and cheaper. Now, this is the same sensor, but this is our standard 25mm lens. And we choose to use this one, which in 16mm movie film is actually considered a wide angle. In 8mm film, this would be considered a little bit of a telephoto. And the 8mm, which is very close to the same size as my CCD sensor on my camera here, this is definitely considered a telephoto lens. So anyway, what I'm trying to get at here is, of course, we might need to finagle focusing a little bit in the video. I'd rather not. I want to kind of leave it stock so people can see what it looks like. But for now, just this quick dirty lens change out gives you an idea. You'll notice that this lens has much more contrast and the colors tend to pop out to you more profoundly. That's because this has got real glass parts in it. So how is Kodak's new 8 Super 8 camera going to compare with, say, the equivalent of a modern digital video camera? Well, if Kodak's using real glass optics and high quality mechanism, From what I've told, the price is a little bit high. A camera could probably seriously have a lot better contrast and color, and will look pretty good. The return of Ektachrome is also going to be great, because that was the return of the last remaining direct reversal film stock, which allows for much more contrast, and it'll stand out better. But unfortunately, the sad truth is that Ektachrome is, or even Kodachrome. I miss Kodachrome.
What is Kodachrome?
Yeah, just like Paul Simon saying, Kodachrome. The nice, bright colors. I gotta play that for Dory, if I can find it. I don't know if she's heard the song, but I don't know if you have, but anyway, I don't ever heard anyone sing too many songs about Ektachrome. Okay, guys, so the point is that there is some developments coming up in the next year or two that may excite some. May make others wish they could take a Salmon X and snore. And the weather is, for New England, has been, unfortunately, kind of in the kind of unpredictable. Right now, for example, temperatures outside is what you'd find in the middle of March at this point. It's not freezing. It's not January-like. We had temperatures a couple days ago that were about 12 degrees Celsius.
That's 50 degrees in English.
But it's 54 degrees Fahrenheit.
Yeah.
Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. People were walking around outside in short-sleeve shirts. In the middle of winter, nonetheless. Okay? For southern New England. Whereas, Eastern Europe in Germany got frozen over in a giant, horrible snowstorm. They were dumping meters upon meters of snow. They got so much snow in the Sierra Nevadas of California that they actually in Colorado, especially in Colorado, they had to close the ski resorts because they couldn't get people to get to the ski resorts because the roads were all jammed up with snow. So the weather has been highly irregular.
It snowed in South Carolina.
Yes, it is right now.
It is snowing there right now?
I don't know if it's still in Colorado right now, but there's an ice storm. There's a big ice storm going on right now in the Midwestern United States.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so we've been blessed because there's a protective spell over Winsted. People don't know this, but there's been a spell in Winsted after the 1955 flood that has protected Winsted from the worst of the worst. That's why Autumn Storm Alfred didn't do any significant damage to Winsted. That's why all the many hurricanes that came through, Gloria, Sandy, Irene, didn't actually do any damage to Winsted. It's because there's a protective spell that also protects us against the severe winter storms as well. Not saying we don't get snow, we do. But like I one time said to people was, that's a protection spell. I don't want to even try removing because it's doing us all a big favor. It's keeping Winston safe. Anyway, so tomorrow we'll be possibly Monique. We'll be on camera again. I don't know. She said she's got a lot of things going on. She said she might be able to do a cameo visit now and then, so I know that Here Gear likes the videos with the rapport with me and Monique. And I don't know if he's really too much into you, Dory. I have to be honest. I don't know much.
Nobody likes me anymore.
Well, I know there's one of my fans that likes you, but I mean, it's just, I don't think we got the same kind of rapport as me and Monique have.
Some people have better.
Well, I mean, like, it's just, we're different people. I mean, you're different than Monique. You're not Monique. You know?
Right.
That's obvious, right? Okay, Dory's not Monique, and Monique is not Dory. It's just a different personality. So I don't know how my audience feels about that.
Well, why don't you audience comment about that? I mean...
Well, take a look at the videos. Me and Monique did on Tuesday. You watched it, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's almost like there's a whole different kind of conversation style. I think Michelle's saying she can see hamming up a little bit for the camera.
She what?
Well, I can ham it up with Dory, too, but I got a feeling some of my stuff might not be well received.
I don't understand what you're trying to say.
We'll watch the video from Thursday, now I think you'll understand. Alright, guys. Anyway, listen. I'm going to try to do some new videos. The VU meter kit is on its way. It was received by the United States customs people from China. And I don't know when and how long it's going to take to go through that and then go into the regular mail system from Hong Kong. But as soon as I get it, I will let you know. And of course, we also got the, coming up, we have the new dress I bought. And yes, I found my original white dress. Dory thought she threw it out. She didn't, and I still had it.
God forbid if I did. The whole house would fall down.
Maybe not. But right now, we're missing one of our lenses. So we got to find one of our camera lenses. And then don't forget Michelle.
We'll try to find that today. We'll look around the house today. We'll try to find that.
I think it's probably just rolled under somewhere.
Yeah, we'll try to see.
Or it could have fallen off the table in the back there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think Michelle had it maybe on the stereo cabinet. Maybe it could have fallen behind it.
We'll see what we can do. We'll look for it today.
We'll look for it. It's not that big anyway. It's not really a high priority item. But, you know, like I said, it's better of the two of the cheap CCTV camera lenses. Because the only thing is it's a fixed focus 6mm and it's a fixed aperture variable focus 6mm. It's kind of an in-between this camera, and then we have the black lens I had on the camera before,
mm-hmm.
and that was what they call a variable focus, variable aperture, so which you had a variable aperture and focus, but let's put it this way, the quality just wasn't in there.
Yeah.
And then we're using this lens right now, which is from the 1930s, which obviously is fixed focus. With variable aperture, variable focus, variable aperture, but it's fixed angle, wide angle. It's not a zoom telephoto, whatever. All right, guys. So tomorrow will be another day. We'll try to get some more videos in, and so we'll see you guys tomorrow.
Bye. Have a good evening. Good day.
Bye, bye, guys.